Hello and welcome to this video review of the Elgato Cam Link. You may hear some fireworks in the background, it's New Year's Eve, so yeah, forgive me for that if I can't remove it in post. But yeah, this is a review of that handy little thing that turns your DSLR camera into basically a webcam. And does it actually do that? Because for me, why I bought this thing is because capture cards normally came with lots of software that you needed to use, and I didn't want that. And this was advertised as a normal webcam, so you could use it with Skype, with Discord. And I've done some tests, and yeah, I'm actually very happy with this thing. So just when you have a look at the box, it's very small. It's a lot smaller than I expected. It has lots of unnecessary packaging, but it is nice to look at. In the box, the main box, you get another cardboard box with the Elgato logo on it, and when you open it, you get the Cam Link, of course. You get an extension cord, so when you want to plug it in at the backside of your PC and there isn't any room, you don't have to put any strain on the USB hub. You can just put the extension cord in there and it won't be a problem at all. You get a sticker, why you would ever use that, I don't know, and a manual, which I haven't even read through because it's so simple, you really don't need the manual. But yeah, using this thing is extremely easy. You just take one side with the HDMI in, and you connect it with an HDMI cable, of course, and the other side of that HDMI cable goes into your camera. Of course, you can use conversion cables for mini HDMI, stuff like that. That does work. It doesn't need to be a normal HDMI connection. And then at the other side, you just put it into your PC. I did it at the start because I use it at the front of my PC, but as you can see, it put a little bit of strain on the USB hub, so I didn't want it to maybe damage the PC. So I decided to put it on the extension cord. So then you just put it in the extension cord and connect it to your PC. Of course, through an USB 3.0 hub. And after you have done that, you get the sound from Windows that it recognizes the Cam Link. Sometimes you can also get a pop-up message from Windows that says we are preparing the Cam Link. And after that, it's basically ready to go. Discord will recognize it, OBS as well. You can find it under video capture device, more on that later. But at the beginning of the PC part, I want to go into the game capture software from Elgato itself, because that's the main thing, of course. And well, it didn't work for me at first. It said detecting signal, and it didn't show anything else, and I was thinking, why isn't it working? But then I thought, wait, maybe the anti-malware software is stopping the Cam Link from working, because this isn't really recognized as a capture device by Windows, but just as a normal webcam. So most virus softwares have a function that blocks the webcam from being used. So I right listed the Cam Link on there, the programs that use it, and yeah, afterwards it worked. So when you start up the software and the Cam Link isn't hooked up to your PC, it says no signal, but as soon as you link it, it will change very quickly to your signal, so that may be 1080p 30, for me it's 1080p 60 as you can see. It also works with this camera, which is 1080p 50. So yeah, and this is about the quality that you can expect. I'm using the Cam Link now with the G7 from Panasonic, and this is just a kit lens, so 800 ISO at the moment. As you can see, not that much noise. So yeah, I'm very happy. The quality is pretty good. I have nothing to complain about. They say it's uncompressed, but yeah, I don't know. I can't test that, so I have to take their word. But overall, the Elgato game capture software worked just as expected. The only thing that I would want to try is also use it with gameplay. So try to record my PC, but that wasn't possible because it isn't recognized as a display. So when I hook up the out of my video card, the NVIDIA software won't recognize it as a display and won't put out the screen on the Cam Link, so I couldn't record it even though I have a second monitor. I need a splitter for that, HDMI splitter, and I don't have that, so... But I've seen online that it does work that way. And yeah, if you have a console, you can also use this as a capture card. It does have instant game view, as you could see in the Elgato game capture software. So yeah, that's very nice. So it's just a capture card, and it doesn't have that software limitation that the other Elgato cards have. So that's very nice. And with OBS, as I say, let's just jump to my OBS screen at the moment. And there we have the screen window effect. But let's go to studio mode, so the screen actually won't change. If we go back to webcam, so this was the screen I was just on. You can see here the Cam Link. How I added this is just right click, add video capture device. And then you can just select the device, and then the Cam Link will be on here, of course. And that's it, that's all you need to do. The only problem that I've seen is when I restart it, or when I unplug the Cam Link and replug it later on, I get just a black screen sometimes, so it will just look like this, even though the eye is on, of course. I don't know why it does that, but what you need to do then is just go to the properties, deactivate, activate, and for me it always worked then. So yeah, that's it. And yeah, this is how it works with other software as well, as you can see here in the video settings of Discord. Sorry it's Dutch, but yeah, it's Dutch, I'm Dutch, so but in the camera settings, it's just you select Cam Link just like in OBS, and when you press test video, it will show up. Of course, it's now black because OBS is using it at the moment, but you won't have any problems with that. So, yeah, you have seen how it works now, and you have seen how easy it is, and what quality you can expect from this. Of course, the only problem that you might find is that your camera isn't comfortable with the Cam Link. So they actually do have a spreadsheet on their website, Elgato, but I didn't find it was very clear, so just try to find if your camera is comfortable with the Cam Link. I have seen this camera being used with the Cam Link before, the G7, so I knew it worked, so I bought it. But as I said, it also worked with this camera. The only thing is, you need to have a clean HDMI out, otherwise things will show up on screen. But yeah, make absolutely sure, just by connecting your camera to a television, that you have a clean HDMI out. And if you don't know what that means, it's just that it's just you and nothing else on the display. And of course, that you can use, if you want, that you can use a dummy battery. So you can put your camera into a wall socket, so you can charge it the whole time, so you can use it for a long time without the battery dying. So in conclusion, what's this for? Well, of course it's for streamers, or people who want to record videos. That's what I'm gonna use it for as well. I don't like the quality of webcams. I even bought this microphone before I did anything in YouTube. I bought it for Skype because I hated voice quality from headsets. And the same goes with this. I also want to use this for now Discord, because that has replaced Skype. But that's why I wanted to use it. But another very big part for when you're making videos is, at least if you live in Europe. In Europe you have the very annoying thing with certain cameras, also with the G7, where you have a recording limit of 29 minutes something. Or when you use 1080p 60, it's 20 minutes something. After that, at least with the G7, it will just stop recording. There used to be a fix for that, but with the newer versions of the G7, like the one I have, that isn't possible. I can put it to 60 FPS as you can see here, but that recording limit is still here. So when I'm recording videos, sometimes the camera just stopped working without me knowing. And that of course is very annoying. But with this, I have an HDMI cable of 5 meters, so I can put this anywhere in my room. I can have it on the tripod, and instead of recording to a little memory card, why doesn't it focus? Oh well, you know how a memory card looks, what a memory card looks like. But instead of recording to a memory card and then having to put it on your hard drive, you can just record to the hard drive immediately and circumvent the recording limit as well. Of course, take into account that some cameras turn off automatically if you don't press a record button. So again, test that out before you buy the Cam Link. But otherwise, I think it's a good purchase. People say it's a little bit on the steep side with €130 or dollar. Normally I would agree, but since this is just a capture card with any 1080p 60 without a delay and without any software restrictions, I don't think it is too bad if you compare it to other capture cards. But yeah, with that, I come to the end of my video, so thank you all for watching and see you all next time. Bye!